Hi everyone, it's a great pleasure for me to be a part of this event, being the ambassador of iGen. And I'm Geoffrey Jayesh from AVL India Private Limited, an Austrian-based company. I'm responsible for testing and development of electric vehicles and fuel cell electric vehicles. So today, let's have a glance on the different types of components which are present inside the electric vehicle, as well as the opportunities in the field of electric vehicles. Okay, let's jump into the topic. In the beginning, let's know why is there a different sudden shift from petrol and diesel vehicles to a electric vehicle market. Okay, so the main reason is similar to the goals of iGen, the UN SDG goals, pollution, global warming, and so on. So the Indian government is focusing on two important things for the future. One is solar, and the second is electric vehicles, of course. So let's have a look at the different types of electric vehicles that are present in the market right now. So the first thing at the left you can see is the representation of a petrol or diesel engine cars. You can see a tank which is filled by petrol or diesel from outside, and it has an IC engine. So the next thing is the hybrid electric vehicle. Hybrid in the sense, it's kind of same like what you have in your mobile phone, the hybrid SIM slot. So it can accommodate both the SIM or a SD card. So in the same way, it has engine as well as a battery. So the battery supplies power to the motor. So next thing is plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, which can be charged from outside. So that is plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. Next thing is pure hybrid electric vehicle. So it has only a motor and a battery, and it can be charged from outside. The final and the future thing is fuel cell electric vehicle. And the fuel cell electric vehicle has hydrogen as a fuel, and it is sent to the fuel cell, and it is capable of charging the battery and driving the motor. So these are the different types of electric vehicles, and let's have a look at different components which are present inside the electric vehicle. First, on the left you can see a battery, which is a high voltage DC supply, and this DC supply is capable of supplying to the whole vehicle. So it is sent to an inverter, and it will be converted from DC to AC, and it will be sent to the motor. Okay, so next we have some components like audio system, wipers, headlamps, everything. So it has it is capable of working with 12 volt or 24 volt alone. So for that we have a DC to DC converter, which is stepping down the higher voltage DC to a lower voltage DC. So next, the important thing is charging. We have two options. One is AC charging. So it is done by using an onboard charger. This is how we charge from our household appliances. So next thing is a DC charging, which is fast charging. It can charge the vehicle in 1 hour, within approximately 1 hour. And the normal charging, it will take around 8 hours to 10 hours approximately. So this is a view of how the vehicle look from the inside. And let's discuss about these three main components of the electric vehicle: the battery, inverter, and the motor. Okay, so the first thing is a battery. And if you take the what we usually say is this is a battery, but this particular cell is a cell in a automotive industry. So what we basically call it as a battery is combination of cells with a kind of management and control. So this will be arranged in a parallel and series combination. This is how it works. So the next thing is why we basically select lithium for the battery mostly. So the main reason is from the periodic table, if you are familiar with chemistry. So the position of lithium in the periodic table, so this is having high electropositivity, and you can just have a look at the different components in the periodic table. Now scientists are working with sodium, graphite, and those things which can form as an alternative. So if you are well known and you have interest in this chemistry, you can also work on that. So next thing is inverter. So the main purpose of inverter is it converts AC to DC and DC to AC. It converts the DC power supply from the battery and it sends to the motor as a AC, and in the same way while regenerating it comes back, the it gives back the AC power and it converts it as a DC and gives it to the battery. So next thing is the main one, which is the e-motor. So the motor is basically of two types, DC as well as AC. So the DC motors is basically used for two-wheelers and three-wheelers. This picture shows belt-driven motors as well as hub motor. And next, the AC motors are basically used for bigger appliances like cars, trucks and those things. So there are different types also, asynchronous motor, synchronous motor, reluctance motor and so on. So apart from that, we have lot of components. So in the part which we saw before, there are opportunities for electrical engineers, electronics engineers, mechanical engineers in motor and so on. Now we can focus on different chips or PCB boards which are totally programmed, like inverter controls, battery management system which controls the whole battery pack, the vehicle management system, hybrid management system and so on. So these chips not only involves the work of electronics engineers but also computer engineers for programming them. We basically use a lot of programs for coding. So there are opportunities, equal opportunities for all the fields. That's what I actually meant to say. So next, we can have a look at different two-wheelers and four-wheelers in the market right now. So there are lot many coming in the future. You may have heard of Ola Electric. So it is being said that it is one of the world's largest two-wheeler manufacturing plant it is going to put up in Hosur. Okay, so let's discuss about different opportunities for entrepreneurs next. So it is very important to discuss this. One is charging station. So at present we have fuel filling stations, and in the future it will definitely be replaced by electric vehicle charging stations. So this is one of the opportunity. The next thing is retrofitting. Retrofitting in the sense we can have a already available petrol or diesel car and we can convert it into an electric car by installing motor, battery and inverter in it. So this is retrofitting. So this is actually booming in the present days. So these are different opportunities in this field. So if you have any doubts, do let me know in the comments, or you can also text me or call me personally. So hope you are capable of selecting the field you want to work in the future right now. So don't delay to select the topic and work towards it. So have a bright future. All the best. Thank you for the opportunity.